3D lab prints, 3D printed RC airplanes are a piece of art. There is not much more to say. I have been flying RC airplanes for the last 20 years, so I really wanted to get one of the 3D printed planes for myself. This is the first video of a video series in which I'll show you how I properly made one of these planes. In this video, I'll show you how I figured out the optimal print settings to get one of these beauties up in the air. Guten Tag everybody, I'm Stefan and welcome to CNC Kitchen. I had my first RC airplane almost 20 years ago, but never flew much since, as a small kid, I always was afraid to crash it and put that hobby aside for many years. Around 10 years ago, I got back into the hobby with my Easy Star, started doing FPV and also built quad and tricopters. So quite a while ago, I saw the pictures of the Czech 3D lab print planes that are printable on most home desktop printers, but never managed to print one, even after the Spitfire model was available for free for everyone who bought an original Prusa i3 Mark II. So this winter I thought it would be the time to finally print one for myself, and I contacted the guys from 3D lab print if they would provide the files for this video series, which they kindly did. They have a whole range of different planes for sale, from trainers to World War II models to EDF jets. The 3D models they sell are not just simply the copies of the outer shell of the planes. They developed a modeling technique which makes all the parts printable as very thin and lightweight structures that don't need supports. The planes are separated into several pieces that are later glued together and equipped with the electronics. If you print the plane in a clear plastic, the internal rib structure becomes visible, which shows the art and craftsmanship that was used to create these models. So even if you are no RC pilot, but love airplanes and lightweight structures, I'd recommend taking a look at their models. The smaller models, like the Spitfire and the Messerschmitt, already start at $20. I'll be printing their model of the Messerschmitt BF-109 because so many already printed the Spitfire, so why not print a good old German plane? Before I start printing the plane itself, I did a lot of tests on finding the optimal extrusion factor, nozzle temperature and fan setting, which I approached with dozens of these specifically designed test specimens. In the next video, I'll then be testing the different gluing techniques and finally, we'll print the parts, assemble everything and get the Messerschmitt up into the air. I'll be printing all of the parts on my current, still unmodified CR10S. I would have preferred my Prusa just because of print quality and reliability, but I thought that these bold style printers became so common these days that more people might be benefiting if I tune the settings for this printer. I also will be using the latest version of Cura for my build and not Simplify 3D, because Cura is free so everybody will have access to it and don't have to spend another 150 bucks for that piece of software. I have chosen Form Futura's transparent premium PLA for the print, not only because my Dutch friends have sponsored a roll, but it also showed the highest strength of PLAs I've tested so far during my filament tests. It is not the most ductile material, so crashing it might end in tears, but it is very stiff and has good interlayer strength. I have decided not to go with PETG because the strength is smaller and, much more importantly, the tensile modulus of it is around 30% lower than the one of PLA, which means that at the same wall thickness it is 30% less stiff. Polycarbonate would also have been an option due to its impact strength, but first, it's way more expensive, and second, the CR10 would not be able to print it without modifications. For the test, I have designed a special tensile test specimen that is printable with only a single outline and is reinforced at the end to prevent it from crushing when I clamp it in my test machine. This should be a nice representation of the structure we'll print later. I used Atomic Green Premium PLA for all of my tests because I didn't want to use up all my transparent material, and I assume the results should be pretty much the same. Two key printing parameters that the manual mentions that need to be tuned are nozzle temperature and extrusion multiplier. With higher temperature, layers usually fuse together better, and extrusion multiplier tunes the amount of material that is pushed out of the nozzle during printing. Higher values lead to thicker walls, but usually also better adhesion between the layers. Due to my previous experience, I started with a nozzle temperature of 200 centigrade and increased it in 15 degree steps up to 245 degrees Celsius. For each temperature, I printed two samples at 100%, 105% and 110% flow, weighed them and ripped them all apart. When we take a look at the results, we can nicely see that with increasing flow we get more strength, and also higher temperatures lead to higher strength up to the point where at 245 degrees Celsius we have a huge drop of the properties again. If we also consider the weight of the samples, it gets even more interesting because we see that with the same extrusion multiplier, more material gets extruded at higher temperatures. So if we take a look at the strength per weight, the mass of our parts increased disproportionately in comparison to the strength, so an extrusion factor of 105% seemed to be the optimum. Since the difference between 215 degrees and 230 degrees Celsius is not that high, I will probably decide later which temperature to choose depending on the print quality. Another interesting point I have investigated is part cooling. 3D LabPrint recommends not to use a fan for the parts to increase strength, but I wanted to find out how high the effect really is on my CR10. Therefore, I printed another set of test samples at 230 degrees Celsius, 105% flow and fan settings of 0, 33, 66 and 100%. The results might be a little counterintuitive at first, because full fan and no fan at all show the lowest average strength values. With both settings I had one outlier which lowered the average quite a bit. The outliers might result from printing errors due to insufficient or too much cooling, or is just general scatter of the results. In my opinion, the results are pretty constant, so the influence of cooling is small, at least for my CR10S. Because first, the cooling fan and nozzle are pretty bad, and second, the heatsink cooling fan also blows quite a bit on the heater block and the part. Also, the layer times are pretty long, so the previous layer is probably cooled down regardless of a cooling fan. If you have another cooling setup, I'd still not go for full cooling because the influence might be detrimental. So maybe print some sample parts at different settings and choose the lowest fan setting that still delivers good print quality. So I printed a couple of wingtips with and without fan at 215 and 230 degrees and, even though the difference is small, stringing is reduced with lower temperature and 50% cooling fan. What do you think? Should I go with a better print quality but maybe slightly reduced strength, or should I aim for maximum strength regardless of the quality? I guess we have figured out general print settings quite well. 105% flow and print temperatures between 115 and 230 degrees give really good results. I might try to optimize things like retraction, wipe, coasting and so on in the next parts, since I have noticed quite severe blobs at the endpoints during printing and there are some visible holes in the outer shell. In the next video, I want to investigate different methods of gluing the parts together. 3D LabPrints recommends CA glue, but do we get better results with expensive super glue, or might even be two-part epoxy a better choice? How about solvent gluing PLA with acetone? If you have any suggestions or experience, then please let me know in the comments and I'll try to include them. Winter is probably over and I really want to finish this project during spring, so the next parts will be out in the next couple of weeks. If you enjoyed the video and liked my approach, then please leave a thumbs up, it really makes a difference. Subscribe if you want to see more of this in the future and consider becoming a Patreon. If you would like to buy a CR10, then take a look at the discounted link in the description that helps me run my channel. Thanks for watching, auf Wiedersehen, and I'll see you next time.